Horvat breaking in. Deeks score.
Right there alone. And he's stopped by Zelko.
Score. Brock Besser.
I heard we're getting a couple of Swedish twins.
Swedish twins? I thought that was just a myth. Like Bigfoot.
This is gonna be awesome.
They're here.
Here they are.
Swedish twins.
Hey, what's up?
Got a couple of Lunas.
I got a tune in.
Oh, cool.
Daniel, Henrik. Henrik, Daniel. Ballet on blades. Red-headed blades. Been 4 years now, I bear witness to your art. And yet, I still can't tell you dudes apart. Human eclipse. Rhinoceros hips. Who will laugh last when I slash your calf? Bring me peace, make it cease. Get your big ass out of my crease. Corey Schneider, great guy. Andrew Raycroft, apple pie. I like all my backups, oodles and oodles. Except Jamie McLennan. Noodles, noodles. First he fed me cannelloni, then he ran me over with a Zamboni. I call this one Lou. Lou. That's all I got for that one. It's just beautiful on its own. ...65 minutes, then a stupid gimmick, tarnishing my name after a 48 save game. 5-on-5, I'll keep you alive. 4-on-4, you will not score. Then you, shootout, I despise you. I will not lie. Why can't we just end it in a tie? Your golden glow makes me quiver. The way you feel on my skin, I shiver. I lusted for you, my dream come true. You belong to me, eternally.
I've set up a mathematic brain teaser, engineered by Kevin Bieksa.
We got Zach Cassian, 22 years old, OHL product. The reason we did this is because he thought that, he's like, oh, I'm really good at algebra. Like, really? Like, you're good? Like, you're good at algebra?
Oh, you should have heard some of the questions last night. We asked him how many muscles were in the quadriceps. He's like, man, no one can answer that. So I was like, no one can answer that. What else?
Yeah. Was that the answer there, bud?
I know. I came back.
How about a baker's dozen? How many in a baker's dozen? He goes, I don't even bake.
Other than that line that had a great night, how did you think your team played?
Other than what?
The line that produced your goals.
So other than them,
Santorelli, Higgins,
how do I separate them? They're part of the team. I don't know. I didn't watch every line individually. I felt like we played well. What do you think? You're asking that question for a reason. Who didn't play good tonight?
I don't know. I have to go back. I thought it was awesome. One of those games. You guys.
The Deans become Hawks. Will they still be sisters?
Well, they'll never become Hawks. I don't think we've got them on our team.
When you have comments like Boland, I mean, obviously an individual whose IQ is probably the size of a birdseed, and he's got a face that only a mother could look at.
It's one of the feel-good hockey stories of the season. Roberto Luongo and Corey Schneider.
All right, smile, guys, smile.
Two-star goalies. Who have put egos aside for the good of the team.
All right, number one. See you, number one.
We get along great. Nobody cares who's number one. We're not petty like that.
Hey, Lou, you got a six-letter word? Clue is opposite of to move forward.
Back up.
Yeah, that fits.
Roberto's just such a generous guy. He doesn't even care about this whole who's number one, who's number two thing.
Schneins, hey. Got you something, man.
Oh, thanks, bud. I really appreciate that. It's really nice of you, I guess. Oh, come on, man. Are you serious?
The media blows this number one, number two thing out of proportion. It's irrelevant to us.
Go ahead, man.
No, you go first, man.
No, I insist. Go ahead.
Okay.
Ah! Come on!
At the beginning of the season, people said, how could two ultra-competitive guys who want to be in the net every night coexist? But they've made it work, showing a level of maturity and professionalism seldom seen these days.
Number two?
Nope, number one.
You guys just seem like such good pals. Corey, you must have loved it when Roberto did his poetry. People just ate that up.
Human eclipse, rhinoceros hips. Who will laugh last when I slash your calf? Bring me peace, make it cease. Get your big ass out of my crease.
Yeah, that was great. I mean, he's just so talented and funny. That should have been me. I would have been so awesomer. Louie, Fooey. There's a reason Corey rhymes with glory and Lou rhymes with number two.
Chines.
Huh?
You okay, man?
Yeah, I'm good. I was just thinking about the six saves he made the other night.
Okay.
And Roberto, it must be great for you to have someone you get along with after that horrific incident in Florida when Jamie McLennan was jealous and ran you over with a Zamboni.
Yeah, man, that was a really difficult time for me, but Schneids and I, we're like brothers.
Brothers.
Little help here. Could use a trainer.
Looks like Lou is starting tonight.
Hey boys, welcome back to another Epi. Jacob, what are we doing today?
We're here with the big D-man Tanev. We're gonna teach him some fundies to move players in front and maybe drag the blue line, get some shots off. So pay attention, this first one, you just wanna do short cross checks on the spine to let him know you're there. You'll never get a penalty like that.
You won't?
No.
Okay, I'll try it out right now. Where you want me to hit him here?
Anywhere in this area.
Like 6 inches right here?
Just nice little short ones. Okay. Really make sure he knows you're there.
Put some power into it. Okay, maybe not.
It's getting better. So this one is a standard in any D-man's book.
Yeah.
It's the standard canny. You want to go through the legs and really send them forwards. Right. Why don't you see if you can move this big guy?
I'm a big guy, so really try.
He is big.
Through just the leg stick here. Through the legs and then just turn him and throw him.
All right, let's give it a shot.
I think he needs a little bit more stick. All right, since you're having trouble moving us in front of the net,
we're
gonna teach you some drag and really grease your snapper, okay?
All right.
Pay attention. Drag.
That went far.
Why don't you try?
Snapper
really
again.
Really drag it.
So this one's the most basic shot for a D-man.
Okay.
It's the clapper from the Bluey.
Yeah.
And you just want to bury your head and get it as high as possible so you can clear the front of the net for your forwards.
It's pretty good, though. Yeah.
This guy's pretty good.
He's not bad. He may have a shot.
He might. So that's just a basic fundies, a D with the big man Tanny.
That's right, boys. So now you know your toeies, your snappies, your draggies, and how to really get the man out of the way in front of the net.
That's right.